football fans, the 30 Manageables season recap show. You know my gorgeous co-host, Troy Toy Miller, and I, of course, am Victor Van Buren IV. Now, Troy, if I told you to describe this season in one word, what would you say?
Fuck!
Well put, my friend, well put. Now, Troy, me and you both, we watched the title game the other night. Do you feel, after watching that game, that we have a definitive national champion?
Well, I feel like the BCS has its champion, but I feel like college football as a whole is left without a true champion.
Playoff?
Did I say playoff?
It sounded like you said playoff.
I'm not necessarily saying playoff. I'm just saying that if I wanted a computer to determine who was going to be in the national championship game, I'd just turn on NCAA 09 and let the EA Sports engine hash it out itself.
Wow. So what are you saying, though?
I'm just saying there's a lot of football left to be played on the field this year.
I agree. I couldn't agree with you more. I mean, there's a lot of teams out there that are saying, hey, we should have got our motherfucking shot at the national championship.
Snubbed.
Try not to think about what might have been, 'cause that was then, and we have taken different roads. We can't go.
Whoa! I mean, hey, if you're Utah and you're sitting there and you're undefeated, you got your hand up in the air saying, what the fuck, my friend? I mean, we took care of business. And we're on the outside looking in. We're the only undefeated team in the football championship division. So, I feel like you got a little bit snubbed. Maybe if you join a better conference, though, this argument won't be there, Utah. But good season anyway. USC, you're sitting there, you're like, hey, we destroyed the Big Ten champion in the Rose Bowl. I mean, we're tough to beat in November and December. But you know what? You always fuck up in the regular season, and you fucked up in Corvallis. You lost to Oregon State. Yeah, they turned out to be a semi-decent team. But you know what? There's a lot of better one-loss teams than USC out there. I don't think the Trojans have an argument. But now Texas. Texas. McCoy, Brown, they're sitting there saying, hey, early October, we took care of business in the Cotton Bowl. Red River Shootout, rivalry, 45-35. Beat Oklahoma on a neutral field. I mean, me and you saw, hands down, it's one of the greatest games of the season. They went on this brutal four-game stretch and winded up losing to Texas Tech on a last-second play. I mean, oh my goodness, Troy, did you see that play?
I saw the play, Vic, and I'm telling you what, I remember it like the day I lost my virginity when I was 9 years old. I mean, this play, I mean, I was thinking, well, Texas Tech, you gave it the old college try, but Colt McCoy drives down the field, scores. It's a good effort, but the game's over. But then what happens? Graham Harrell, methodical, down the field, gonna throw the quick pick. No. Crabtree. Oh, my God.
Six, baby.
He catches the ball. It's like, God, there's 1 sack at Crabtree. Get down. Get out of bounds. Do something. And he breaks away, and he scores. Oh! Bevo is beside himself.
I tell you what. I mean, that was the play that just threw everything in a fucking shitstorm. And I think that is the play that kept Texas out of it. You remember when they had the Texas paid for that plane to fly over the Oklahoma game they were playing? 45-35.
Money well spent.
Yeah, just seems like a waste now. I mean, because I didn't know it, but the Big 12, they don't count the head-to-head. They go by the highest BCS. I mean, if the head-to-head don't count, I mean, fuck it. Don't even play the Red River rivalry next year. Like Troy said it before, he'll fire up the EA Sports engine. We'll play that motherfucking game. You have to count the head-to-head. I mean, it's decided on the field. 45-35. But if that play didn't happen, the play wouldn't have this common, you know, conversation. But that play did happen. Here's that play. Wow, that was the play of 08. If you ask me and Troy, that was the game of 08. I mean, that game was the shit from the first to the fourth, baby. We're going to show you now some of third and manageable, what we like to call the good, the bad, and the ugly of 08. We can't go through every single week, so we're just going to kind of hint at some of the stuff we liked and disliked in the 08 season. Troy, what's some of the good that came out of the 08 season?
North Carolina Tar Heels. Butch Davis has turned this thing around. Winning season, winning record. Went to a bowl game. Lost it closely, but got a lot to look forward to. How about you, Vic? What's good
for
you?
They fought hard in that game. They sure did. For me, it's got to be my Noles. I mean, not a great season, but you finish it with a win. It's a springboard into the 09 season, which I think has a lot of promise to it.
What about the ACC overall this year?
Oh, good, good, good.
I mean, you're sending 10 teams to a bowl game?
Exactly.
More than any other conference.
Exactly. People talk shit about the ACC. The ACC sent the most teams to bowl games. Several teams had 7 wins or more. So, the powerhouse conference, in our opinion, of the 08 season. The most exciting conference for me, though, in the good category, was the Big 12.
Air it out, baby.
Exactly. The most exciting conference to watch week in and week out. Regardless of bowl games, I mean, everybody in America was tuning in Saturdays to watch the Big 12 just put up those points, baby. What's some of the bad, though? Let's talk about conference. What's some of the bad?
My opinion, the SEC was bad.
Overrated.
I mean, you want to talk about parity. You got Vandy going bowling. Mm-hmm. You got LSU pretty much falling off the map.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, you almost lost at home to Troy.
Exactly.
Just saying.
It was very up and down. I mean, people talk about just the speed and how tough these teams are. You know, the SEC, it doesn't seem like it was that hard to go, you know, through the SEC conference schedule without a loss.
And how about those SEC night games I wanted to see so bad? Where were they?
Let's talk about them, man. You're just hitting it on all cylinders, my friend. The primetime games. We had just a few of the primetime games turn out to be what everybody expected, you know. The better games usually happen at 12 or 3 o'clock. You know, come on ESPN, come on ABC, the family networks. Let's get these primetime games. I know it's not your fault, but maybe we can do a little bit better scheduling. You know, take a look at what happened in 08. Use those teams to play the night games in 09.
Yeah, I mean, we weren't going to bed early or anything, but let's get into the ugly a little bit. The ugly a little bit. The ugly, the ugly, the ugly, the ugly a little bit.